7. So I guess it's Prophetess Calhoun's fault that I got this message.
That's the Lord.
Partially. I think she's partially responsible. Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. You know, like all ministers, pastors, you know, people that are heads of ministries in some form or another, at the end of the year, glory to God. Amen. I don't know what, but I hear restitution for you. Amen. I hear restitution. Amen. You watch God. Glory to God. Amen. It's some things you're owed. Amen. And God said restitution is about to be manifested on your behalf. Amen. God is good. Amen. But like all ministers, pastors, you know, at the end of the year, we're, you know, seeking God for a word that we think will be the theme for the year. And I'm striving to be careful about that because it can become a traditional thing. Y'all got it? Amen. That if you're not careful, it'll make you look beyond what God wants to say. You know, because of the expectation of the people and the atmosphere that surrounds going from one year into another year in Christianity. You know, like it's the thing to do. When God may want to do several things throughout the course of the year. You got, or he may just want, you know, that word to be the word for today. For the people who are here today. And so I'm striving to be sensitive to what, you know, God wants and not just what we traditionally want, you know, during this time. But he did give me a word that I believe, you know, will expand the entire year. But I'm in the point now where I'm not going to be moved by that anymore if that ain't what he wants to do.
All right.
Y'all all right with
Father
that? Amen. And so he began, as I've been praying, he began to talk to me about this particular word. And it has both spiritual and natural application. Amen. That's gonna bless you if you receive it. 1 Corinthians 12. And verse 7, are you there?
Amen.
And it says, but the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal, right? The manifestation of the Spirit are the abilities of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal, right? And there's nothing necessarily wrong with us kind of focusing on the last this word, almost the last word, you know, at the end of that particular sentence, profit, because, you know, we want a profit in life.
Amen.
Right? And I believe profiting in life is of the Lord. Y'all got it? And so there's nothing wrong with that. But really, if you're going to look at this right, it says the manifestation are the abilities of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. So profiting in life is connected to the manifestations of the Spirit.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
So, you know, God don't want you to have the type of prospering that's not overshadowed by the Spirit. how many of y'all understand? Y'all got it, amen. He don't want, glory to God, he don't want us pursuing profit without the influence of the Spirit.
Well.
Y'all with me, amen. Because, you know, prosperity will run a fool.
Oh, my Lord.
And a fool is somebody who's not up under the inspiration of the Spirit.
That's right.
Y'all got it? How many of y'all can see that? Amen. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, the scripture I read earlier, and his righteousness, and then all of these things, right? Seek ye first the spiritual things of God, you know, or keep those things first in your life, because I don't want it to be a one-time event, you know, or year-ending event that we come and do, you know, at the end of the year and the first day of the year, you know, and then bless you. And then the rest of the year, you kind of, you know, pull back on the spiritual pursuit of things, because we're all about the end result, which is the profiting. Right? But it works just like that. You keep spiritual things first. God is a spirit. Right? And the end result is you will profit in life. Y'all got it? And you have to be, you have to be disciplined in that. You know, I say throughout the course of the year, but for the remainder of your life. You got it? Because, see, when we start putting years on it, a year, 365 days, you know, you get this, if I can just hold out to 364, you know, and then, no, this is the rest of my life, right, that I'm pursuing spiritual things, and me profiting is a byproduct of that. How many of y'all understand what I'm saying? Amen. And so what the Lord gave me, he gave me that particular scripture, and I thought it was an odd scripture based on, you know, what we'd be looking for during this time. But he said 2017 would be the year of greater manifestation. Y'all got it? And this is for this house. Now, you go home tonight and turn on the TV, and somebody else might have, the Lord said this was the year of whatever, whatever. I ain't got nothing to do with that.
That's right.
Right? I'm telling you, and I'm not saying they hadn't heard from God. I'm just telling you what God told me to tell this house. Right? And he said that this year would be the year, amen, of greater manifestation. Is that all right? Greater manifestation, amen. And in both spectrums, right? Greater spiritual manifestation, right? And greater natural manifestation that will cause us to profit naturally. Y'all got it? But the spiritual comes first. Y'all got it? And it's going to produce the greater manifestation of the natural things. Is that all right? Now listen, this word manifestation in the context of this teaching is defined as a public demonstration or revelation of a power source. Is that all right? Can y'all get that? It's defined as a public demonstration or revelation of a power source. When something has manifested, it means that you can see it, understand it, and take possession of it for others and for your personal benefit, right? Whenever something is manifested, it means that you can see it, you can understand it, and you can take possession of it. Is that all right? When something is made public, it means that it is exposed or made available for all to view. It means that it's uncovered. Amen. Right? And so what God is going to do in 2017, amen, is he's gonna reveal some things. He's going to expose some things, amen, for all to view. Amen. Right? As it relates to our lives and our connection with him. Amen. It's going to be some spiritual things that he's going to uncover in your life. Oh, God. You ought to want that. Amen. It's going to be some spiritual things that he's going to reveal, amen, to you about you. Glory to God. Are y'all all right? And not for vain glory, but for his glory, you know, the people in your world are going to, amen, see that, and they're going to know that it's something actually spiritually different about you. It ain't just you got a new how-do. Right? But it's something spiritually unique about you in 2017. You got it. And of course, that people are, you know, another terminology for that could be light. And people are always drawn to light. You got it. And so as God revealed to who you are spiritually, glory to God. Amen. As he revealed who you are spiritually, I'm not talking about your name, your last name. You're Kaiser, you know, or Coleman, or Shine, or whatever. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about who you are spiritually. Amen. People are going to be drawn to the Christ that's in you. Glory to God. Amen. And people only seek Jesus for ministry. Those who seek him only seek him because they need him. And say what you want. You have all the money in the world you want. When a rich man seek Jesus, it's because he recognizes I need him. It's something about my life that other people are not aware of. Amen. And only Jesus can fix that. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? Amen. And the Bible said Christ is in you with a hope of glory. Is that all right? Amen. Are y'all all right with that? Amen. And here again, the byproduct of you allowing God to do that in you and in through you is that he's going to cause your life to profit. Amen. Is that all right? This word demonstration or to demonstrate means to show clearly the beneficial end result of a process, right? In the context of this teaching, it means to show clearly, amen, the beneficial end result, amen, of a process. In other words, you're going to have to admit that it's because of your relationship with God these beneficial results have transpired. Right? Amen. Because you're going to know it wasn't based on your own ability. Amen. Right? You're going to have to testify that it was the Lord who was on my side. Amen. He caused these things to transpire. Amen. In my life. Are y'all all right with that? Amen. 1 Corinthians 2:4-5 declares, "And my speech and my preaching was not with enticing words of man's wisdom, but in demonstration of the Spirit and of power, that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of men, amen, but in the power, amen, of God." Is that all right? And so God is about to, in our lives, bring to pass greater manifestation of his Spirit, greater demonstrations, amen, of his Spirit. If you do a background, you know, study on chapter 12, actually, he's talking about the gifts of the Spirit, right? Talking about the gifts of the Spirit, amen. And God is saying, I want more of the gifting of God that's in you to come forth. I want the gifting of God that's in your life to blot you out. Oh, Lord, to outshine you. Amen. Right? Are y'all getting that? Amen. And so he's going to cause that, amen, to be brought to pass. Amen. The Spirit of God also began to talk to me about us, really, as a household of faith. Right? And he was saying that we should be in expectation this year individually for a greater demonstration of the power of God to be manifested in our lives, right? He said that we as a household of faith should be in expectation individually, right? That means everybody say, I'm talking about, he's talking about you. Look at your neighbor, right? Because a lot of times what people do, they come to the house of God and they get in the corporate setting of the house, the corporate atmosphere of the house, and they feel like that there really ain't nothing attached to their lives that needs to be produced. Y'all got it? They want pastor to have a greater manifestation of the things of God. They want the prophets to have a greater manifestation of the things of God. But then personally, as an individual, it ain't really on the radar like it's supposed to be. Y'all got it? And I believe, you know, part of the reason for that is because you're not in expectation for it. You got, you kind of comfortable letting everybody else do what they need to do to have a manifestation. Are y'all all right? But listen, church. It's time for everybody to grow up. I said it's time for everybody to grow up. Y'all got it? Amen. And, man, I don't even know whether I want to say this or not. Okay. Since he's making a little noise, RG up here, right? And he got men servants and maid servants.
Yes, sir.
He got houses he didn't build. Vineyard, y'all got it. He traveled from house to house, cracking the whip. I want to eat. And all that. Right? And there's nothing wrong with that because he's a child.
That's right.
Right? Yep. Nothing wrong with that because he's a child. And that's what you're supposed to do for children. Right? But how many of y'all know that in the very near future, you know, the benefits will still be his, but he might have to get up and get them himself. Right? He get fed, put him in a little chair, you put him in a chair and he go. That's what he going. Because he know when he get in that chair, and if you too slow, somebody's supposed to be bringing him something. Right? And he don't want to hear the little airplane go. No, he won't just put it in my mouth. He'll have his mouth open. Y'all got it. But in the near future, you know, the same men servants and maid servants gonna love him, right? But they're gonna require of him to get that spoon, put it in that plate or whatever he's eating, right? Pick it up and put it in his mouth, right? And don't be spilling it all over everywhere and everything. And all. Y'all gonna, my point is, at some point in time, he's gonna have to grow up. Y'all got it. And I'm telling you, God, dumb, he said, you're going to have to make him grow up.
Amen.
Y'all are. He told me, I'm telling you, you cannot do everything for them. You're going to have to make them grow up. It doesn't mean you don't love them, and don't you let them make you think you don't love them.
Amen.
Y'all, but you're going to have to make them grow up. Y'all got, and then this really got to me. He said, because at a certain age, Sister Shine cannot carry RJ.
No, that's good. That's good.
Did y'all hear that?
Yes, sir.
Not that she don't want to carry him. At a certain age, she cannot carry him. Should not carry him.
Amen.
Are you hearing? Because that would be detrimental to her physical health. Because he'll be too big. Too heavy. Right? And so for her own good, y'all got it. Not because she don't love him. She gonna put him down and say, come on, I'm going this way. And if he wanna go, he go. And God began to talk to me. He said, even spiritually, at a certain age, you cannot carry them. That's what he told me. He said, you can't carry them at a certain age. He said, it's detrimental to your health. If you try to carry them when you're not supposed to carry them. Right? You become an enabler to them, you know, keeping them from growing and developing. Y'all got it? And it's going to affect you. Y'all got it? Amen. And so it's time for everybody to grow up. Everybody's supposed to have demonstration. Everybody's supposed to have manifestations. of the things of God in their lives. Y'all got it? And God will help all of us to do that. Yeah. Right? Y'all all right with that? So he said, begin to talk to the whole household about having an expectation this year individually, right, for greater demonstrations or manifestations of the power of God in their lives. Y'all got it? One more time, look at your neighbor and say, he's talking about you. One of them, see? Talking about you. Right? Look at him and say, look at your neighbor and say, look, listen. No more surviving on other folks' manifestations. Do I have the right bunch up in here? No more surviving on other folks' manifestations. Now listen, don't translate that into you can't ask nobody to pray for you and pray with you. You can't call nobody to touch and agree with you. Right? Don't translate that into you can't seek counsel if you need counsel. Y'all got it? Amen. But all that surviving on other folks' manifestation, the Lord said that's over with. Not unless you got saved last week. Y'all got it? Amen. So, and he said, get this. He said, have an expectation for a greater manifestation and demonstration in your life. He said, and get this. He said, and this greater manifestation of power and demonstration this year will not be for you only. He said, will not be for you only. Because he said, a lot of times what happens is that people spend the entire year and the entire year be just all about them. Trying to get God to do what you want. Boy, man, my goodness. This is pastoring, y'all. Trying to get God to do only for you. The entire year. Y'all got it? And then when we go into the next year, you know, unless you hear a word like this, the next year is also all about you. And you never get to the place where you become active in the ministry of the body of Christ. Y'all got it? Y'all all right? Because the whole year, it's all about you. Right? Like God is not concerned about you. Y'all got it? Listen, like he can't handle you and somebody else you know too. Let's see. And so we can't have, as members of the body of Christ, this attitude of, I got mine, you get yours. You know what I just heard? If Jesus was here physically, this is how he would be talking. He'd be asking you questions like, are you your brother's keeper? Woo! Are you your sister's keeper? When the last time you called and checked on somebody else? God put you on my heart. I've been praying about you. I've been praying for you. Y'all got it? And so he said that this manifestation, this demonstration will not be for you only. He said, but there are people already that he has assigned for you to bless and to minister to. And he wants you to be willing and ready to do so. That's our word for 2017. Right? People already. That he's assigned for you to be a blessing to and for you to minister to. You got it? And that needs to be our expectation.
Right.
Y'all got it?
Yep.
Can y'all handle that? He also told me to tell you to be confident, because it won't even be by your own ability that these things will take place.
Glory to God.
Because a lot of times what holds people back is this attitude of when God tells you to do something, you got to do it in your own strength or based on your own ability. You got it? And that's not the case. In Zechariah 4:6, it says, "Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, This is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel. He said, Not by might, nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts." You got it? And so what God is going to do in you and through you is not going to be by your own personal ability.
Thank you, Lord.
Y'all got it? Amen. It's going to be by his spirit that he's going to use you and get these greater demonstrations and manifestations out of your life. How many of y'all want that? Y'all awful quiet like y'all don't want that. Did nobody tell you this is what it was going to be about when you got saved? Right? That God was going to save you in hopes of being able to save somebody else through you. And in the meantime, he's going to take care of you. Right? So if it's going to be by his spirit, that means that the individual success this year of every individual is going to be based on your personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God. If what he's going to do in me and through me is going to be by his Spirit, that means my individual success is going to be based on me personally being able to hear from God. But that's good stuff right there. I said that's good stuff right there. You see, God is tired of us being able to blame somebody else for what has not happened. What should have happened, could have, would have happened. Right? My success is going to be based on my personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God.
Right.
Not by power, nor by might, but by my spirit, saith the Lord.
All
right. Y'all got to touch your neighbor and say, "You still in here?" Say, "Why are you so quiet?" He writing it down. That's a good thing. Well, I just said it's a good thing. It's a good thing, right? You got it? And we're a corporate body, and we got people here you can still bounce things off of and ask to pray with you and so forth and so on. But God is saying your success this year is going to be based on your personal ability to hear from God. And you really want that. You know how I know? Because the first time somebody hears something from God for you that you don't want to hear, you be like, "No, I hear from God myself." Well, praise the Lord. We need to be a church full of folk.
Amen.
From the pulpit to the door that can hear from God. Amen. For themselves. That's what God want.
Yeah.
That's what I want.
Amen.
That ought to be what you want.
Amen.
Right? Because it is the Spirit that's going to cause us to profit. All right, see? So you can't be looking at somebody else who heard from the Spirit and they followed his leading and his direction and God prospering in their lives and causing them to profit and think, "Well, you know, there's something wrong with that. That's not fair," and so forth and so on. But they done what it took to hear from the Spirit of the Lord. Right? And I'm going to tell you something, whether you realize it or not. I hope you agree with me. Everybody in here in 2017 heard something from the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Every last one. Every last one. If you come to this church on a consistent basis, you're not even a consistent basis. You just showed up, stumbling here. You heard something from the Spirit of God. And I'm telling you, outside of these four walls, you heard something.
Amen.
From the Spirit of the Lord.
Amen.
Right?
Yes.
You know, why would God only talk to you up in here?
My God.
When you need him out there.
Amen.
Right?
Yes.
Am I making spiritual sense to you?
Yes.
So he said, if it's going to be by his Spirit, that means that your individual success this year will be based on your personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God. Y'all got it? Let me tell you something. Talking to you and me is something he wants to do. You know, because I feel that trepidation and fear. Yeah. Talking to you, I'm talking to you. He's telling me to tell you, is something that he wants to do. It's not anything that he don't want to do. Right. The question is, do you want to hear from him? Woo, you're preaching real good, Pat. I'm glad we took the offering up. My goodness. Revelation 2 and 7 says, he that have an ear. Man, what y'all pastors talk about on New Year's, the New Year? Man, he talked about hearing from God, talked about hearing from the Holy Ghost. That's what he said. Huh? He says, he that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. That's Revelation 2 and 7. Now, it's two points I want to make. I'm almost through, y'all, on this text. Just want to get y'all enough to get over your withdrawals from last night. People calling my house, telling me, we just checking to see we're not the party over your house.
Amen.
I said, no, ain't no balloons over here. Y'all just be on time tomorrow. But there's two points I want to make on that particular text. Number one is, even though chapter 2 begins with, if you go up to the first verse of chapter 2 of Revelation, it begins with, unto the angel of the church of Ephesus write. Right? Even though it begins with that chapter, the phrase, he that have an ear, is not just for the angel of the house. Y'all got it? But it is for everyone that is in the house. Right? He that have an ear, right, is talking about everybody in the house, not just the angel of the house. In fact, Jesus said in St. John 10, 4 through 5, he said, my sheep, not just my shepherd, hears and knows my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. Y'all got it? So Jesus is saying, if you are his sheep, how many sheep in him belongs to Jesus? Let me see it again. Them hands went kind of like, praise the Lord. All y'all sheep belongs to Jesus. Right? Now, Jesus said, my sheep hears and they know my voice. Or they should be able to hear and know his voice. Right? And a stranger, they would not follow. So in other words, the goal of the household, of the whole house this year, needs to be the enhancement of your personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God. That plan. Right? The goal of this household, the whole household, should be the enhancement of your personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God. The pastor sounds like you're trying to put us to work. What's your job? What you going to do? I'm a part of the house. Y'all got? And personally, I'm going to be working on my enhancement. Y'all, praise the Lord. I appreciate that. Y'all got it? Amen. Because it don't seem like too many other folks want to work on their enhancement. They so quiet. I don't know. Y'all think about collard greens and stuff? What? Yeah, where? Y'all got, you know, collard greens ain't going to do nothing but you make you put on some weight. That's all. I mean, that. I'm trying to teach you how to profit. Y'all came to church to learn how to profit today. I know y'all did. Amen. Right? For the word for 2017, right? And I'm telling you how to do it. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm telling you how to do it. Right? You got to increase your enhancement, amen, of your personal ability to hear from the Spirit of God. Right? Amen. This word enhancement means to heighten. It means to increase or to improve upon one's ability to do something. Right? How many of you want to improve on your ability to hear from God? Amen. We need that in this world. We need that. Right? Amen. Now listen, the first thing that you need to do though in this process of enhancing your ability to hear is to develop a listening ear. Seem like y'all working on that right now. I don't know what not y'all. It's because the word is so good that you just want to make sure you don't miss not one jot or tittle, or this ain't really what you want, and you just, you know, mom's the word. It's a good word. I thought it was. He gave it to me. That's what he gave to me. I ain't come up with this on my own, right? But he said, but the first thing that you have to do is to develop a listening ear. And he said, and slow down or just stop your internal talking so much while you're supposed to be listening. And I got down here explained. What that means is, let's say if you and I were in a conversation and you came to me for counsel, right? Right? And I'm counseling you. But all while I'm counseling, you got this internal dialogue going on. Right? Do you know you're not listening? You're not listening? You got this internal dialogue going on, right? While I'm talking to you, right? See, if you don't trust me enough to shut up while I'm talking, my dog. Whoa. Right? Come on. Right? Why are you talking? And I'm trying, you ain't talking to me physically, but you talking up in here. Why you come to me and ask me for counseling, and I'm giving you counseling, and you talking all while I'm giving you counseling? If you knew what you needed before you came, I got a witness out there. Y'all got, I heard Pastor Jakes the other day say something. Well, when he owned like nobody. Jake said, when you come into a room and you outgunned, He said, don't go in there trying to compete. Y'all don't understand the example. Outgun. Y'all know, right. Yeah. You come into a room, right? You got a 9mm and he got an AR-15. You need to hush. Right? It's time to listen to the guy that's got the AR-15. All you got is a 9mm. Don't go in there trying to compete and compare. Right? Because that 9mm might put a hole in your shoulder, but that AR-15 gonna knock you down. Amen. Y'all getting the gist of what I'm saying? And so, you know, y'all's a little offended because I said that, but that's what happened naturally. But the Lord said, when you do it naturally, you do it spiritually too. You don't get a Holy Ghost an opportunity to finish his sentence. When I get up in the morning and pray, the Lord had to jack me up about this some time ago. And I'd say, good morning, Father. Good morning, Lord Jesus. And good morning, Holy Spirit. Right? And I'd say, good morning, Father, and wouldn't even wait for him to say, good morning, David. I'm gone to Jesus, and I'm gone to the Holy Spirit, and then I'm gone down my list. And I found out if when I say good morning, Father, God is my witness, my secret judge. If I wait, he'll say good morning, David. If I say good morning, Lord Jesus, if I wait, he'll say good morning, David. And if I say good morning, and when I say Holy Spirit, I look here. I say good morning, Holy Spirit. If I give him some time, he speaks back to me every time. Every time. And he let me know it was a form of disrespect for me to speak to him and not allow him to speak back to me. And a lot of us spend all our time speaking to him. And we never allow him time to speak back to, because we got to go. We got to go. We got to go. There have been times I have come in here and to pray. And while I'm praying, I'm thinking about I ain't got time. I got to go. And he get offended when I do that. And I had to repent. Lord, I repent of that. I repent of being anxious, of thinking I got to run in here and run out of here and don't take time to. Ooh, it's quiet up in this Presbyterian church. Are y'all all right? So I'm trying to enhance my ability to hear. And so what I have to do first is to develop a listening ear. Y'all got it? I believe that since we have two ears, you don't have two ears just because your head big. Since we have two ears and just one mouth, we probably should do twice as much listening as we do talking. Amen. Since it's like that. Y'all got it? Amen. A long time ago. I was somewhere, I was out of town, another state. I was in a restaurant with a preacher, and we was talking. And every time he said something, I jumped in there behind it. Y'all got, I was outgunned. Oh, my Lord. And in there trying to compare myself. Right? He say something, then I had to show him how much wisdom I had. He say something, I had to show him how much wisdom I had. And he finally told me, listen, you can't get nothing like that. You know, if you got to comment behind everything I say, ain't nothing for me to tell you. I dare him talk to me like that. See, that's what your problem is right there. That's your problem is right there. Can't nobody talk to you. You don't want to listen. Nobody going to talk to me. Tell me when to talk and when not to talk. That's what your problem is. Jesus can't even tell you when to shut up. How you know? Because he done tried. The Lord ought to told you to be quiet.
Yeah.
And you talked anyhow. And it didn't turn out well. Right. He still tell me that from time to time. You know what he said now? He got a different word now. He said, leave that alone. That's all he said, leave that alone. And I wish I could tell y'all. What you grinning about? I heard you. And I wish I could tell y'all that every time he told me that, I left it alone. I wish I could tell y'all that. I wish I could. Are y'all hear what I'm saying? And I'm a whole lot better at it now than what I was. Y'all got it? Amen. But here, sometimes you be finna talk about somebody. It's awful quiet in this First Baptist Church. Getting ready to talk about somebody. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah. Right. Wait, and they wrong. They were wrong. What you finna say about them is the truth. And he'll still tell you, leave that alone. And then he will add this to it. That's not edifying to the person you talking to. All you finna do is put a mote in their eye against somebody else. That's all you finna do. You ain't trying to warn nobody. Now we clove it up. I'm trying to warn you. You don't know her like I know her.
That's how you treat me.
Now all you trying to do is put a mote in somebody, a beam in somebody else's eye. And the Holy Ghost be telling you, leave that alone. Y'all, I'm talking about enhancing your ability. And then you want him to tell you something else, some deep revelation. After he didn't tell you, he can't get you to hush. Help us, Lord. Thank you, Sister Kath. I appreciate it. I'm telling you, man, I'm looking for greater manifestation. What if God want to use you to minister to somebody you know been talking about you?
Wow. It's about him.
Prophet said, work with it back there. You know he'll do that?
Yeah. It's about him.
I have had people to come up in the line for prayer.
Hallelujah.
I ain't telling them I'm guessing about some. I know they've been talking about me. Y'all got it? And he won't even let you. I'm going to pray this prayer, but I ain't going to mean it. He won't even let. Okay. Oh, see, they trying to act like they ain't never been tempted to pray for somebody that they hadn't meant it. I'm telling you. He won't even let me not mean a prayer.
Ooh, that's good. Good
pastor. I see you. Y'all, I see you. What are you talking about? I see you. I see what's in your heart right now. You supposed to bless them that curse you, you know, and do good to them that despitefully you. I see you.
Amen.
See what's in your heart. You better pray honestly for them. You because you don't want to reap that. You don't want nobody telling you, I'm going to pray for you, and they ain't sincere about praying for you because of what they know about you. Care what you know, pray for me. Sincerely. Y'all all right? So the first thing we have to do is enhance our ability to listen, right? And you'll be surprised at how, if you practice that with one another, how that'll parlay over into your relationship with the Lord, right? If I don't have to cut Minister Shine off to get my point in all of the time, when I'm talking to God, it's going to be the same way. And God will have an opportunity to talk to back to me. The Spirit of God will have an opportunity to do what he's been called to do, lead and guide me into all the truth, right? Give me directions in my life. Because I developed that with you guys. See, I can't say I love Elder and then don't treat Elder right. And then, well, say I love God and don't treat Elder right. And then expect to have, you know, a proper relationship with God. That don't work. You know, expect to have proper leading from the Lord. Am I helping anybody? Yes. See. So we got 2 ears, 1 mouth. There's a revelation in that. Right? Ecclesiastes 5:3 says that a fool's voice is known by a multitude of words. Right? Ecclesiastes 5:3. See, when nobody know there was a fool, they just hush. James 1:19 says, therefore, my brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, right? So he's talking about developing your capacity to listen. Isaiah 50:4. Because we're expecting greater manifestations, right, this year. From the Spirit of the living God, right? Both spiritually and naturally. I'm telling you, he finna cause us to prosper. Finna cause us to prosper. Listen, the Holy Ghost knows where all the prosperity is. Right? He knows where the job is. Right? He knows who needs a job. Right? Young lady was in here. Was it Tuesday before last? Is she here today? Okay. But I'm standing up here, and we're finna take up the offer. Holy Ghost says she needed a job. I ain't know she didn't have a job, but the Holy Ghost knew she needed a job. And I told her, I said, you looking for a job? Holy Ghost told me you need a job. She said, yeah, I need a job. She didn't have one. She came up here. We set ourselves in agreement, prayed for her. 7 days from the day, she testified Tuesday. She got the job. Y'all got it? He caused her to profit because somebody had an ability to hear. She didn't even come up and ask me to pray for her and say, I need a job, Pastor. Can you pray for me, right? She didn't even do that, right? Holy Ghost knows everything. When she came up and I grabbed her hand and prayed for her, I saw her feet turn into roots. And roots, R-O-O-T-S, roots. That's the language police, man. The grammar police. Y'all been running with Evie, ain't you? Yeah. I saw what? Roots. Her legs turned into roots and planted themselves into the foundation of this building. And so I just started telling her, you know, this is a good foundation. I see, you know, your legs like root done planted itself into this foundation. And she said, yeah, I want to join the church. And to open the doors of the church police, they got me out of the church. But my point is, the Holy Ghost knew she wanted to join the church. And the Holy Ghost knew she needed to be planted. She needed to put her in this church. Y'all, are y'all hearing what I'm saying? And so she joined the church that night, and 7 days later she got the job. All because somebody could hear what the Spirit was saying to the church. Well, that just ain't for me. That's for the whole house. if you'll learn to listen. When I walk out that door and come up here, I'm listening all the way down the aisle. When I'm standing here in praise and worship, I'm listening. When I'm standing up there in that pulpit, I'm listening. I'm listening right now. I'm listening because I'm developing my ear to hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Are y'all getting the gist of what I'm saying? Amen. And so God wants us all to have that. Man, he wants you on the job with that. He wants you taking care of business with that. He wants you on the car lot with that. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? He wants you listening in every area of your life because he got something to say about it. Isaiah 50:4. Because we're looking for greater manifestation this year. And the manifestation is tied to your ability to hear. Right? God has no respect to person. But he is a respect of listeners. He can get more to a person who listens than he can a person who doesn't listen. Isaiah 50. I'm almost there, y'all. I know y'all. And verse 4, it says, the Lord have given me the tongue of the learned. I think that I have that. Amen. That I should know how to speak a word in season. Amen. To him that is weary. All right? Amen. See, you can only do that if you're willing to listen. You can't look at somebody who's weary in their spirit and you just come up with something you want to say to them. You got to hear from the Spirit of the Lord what to say and how to say it. Because sometimes people hear what to say and they don't say it right. Y'all got it? And it doesn't mean you weak because you don't lay the axe at the root of the tree. It means you are wise. Because the Bible said, he that winneth souls is wise. So sometimes you can't just approach a person straight up talking about their problem, their issues you see. Amen. Why are you doing that? How come you? Great, said all up in her business. Sometimes you have to go around and come back another way. Sometimes you let the Holy Ghost give you a parable. Sometimes he might want to dip back into the reservoir of your personal experience. And you can use that to lay the groundwork to minister to somebody. Y'all follow me? You just can't just roll up on somebody, you know, just because you see something and gonna deal with it. Yeah, but it's a long time ago. See, he reached back into the well of my experience. You know, a long time ago when I was first ministering and I was fiery, you know, and it was all about what was right. You going to get right around me. Mm-hmm. And I've come out of old school holiness. It's holiness of hell. The Bible is right and somebody wrong. And it ain't me. It ain't me. Got to be you. Y'all got it? Amen. And I had a sword, a spiritual sword that long. It was heavy. I put it up on my head and try to chop your head off. I'd go places and I was sitting in the church one time and the Holy Ghost started showing me stuff. You know, and then I was ready to get it. Then I would. You be getting all out of order. I'm gonna finish my story, but we were at a church one time, and a former minister that was here was running a revival. Y'all got it made now, and We sitting in the pool. I'm sitting in the pulpit. He's sitting in the pulpit. Pastor sitting in the pulpit. A young lady got up, supposed to be a prophetess in the church. She said that she have somewhat of a light rebuke for the elders. And she commenced to rebuking the elders. Well, you know, I'm a worried person.
Yeah, you are.
So scripture's rolling up in me. You know, rebuke not an elder. Not even lightly. So she commenced to rebuking the elders. And I'm looking down the line at the pastor. He ain't said nothing. I look down the line at the guy running the revival. He ain't said nothing. And I took about all I could take, elder. So I got up and walked to the podium. It said, listen, what you need to do is sit down. Because the Bible said, rebuke not an elder, not even lightly. And she turned around and went. Because she was out of order. Man, they'd have stole my time. She was out of order. That wasn't Bible what she was doing.
That's right.
And so that's how I was. And but God had to tell me. He was showing me stuff, and I'm ready to get it. Ask me to have words if you want them. I'm ready to get it. And the Holy Ghost spoke to me. He said, but see, I'm learning how to listen. He said, don't you bother stuff unless I tell you to. Because I was an apostle. I felt like I had the authority to do it. You know, just because you got authority don't mean you got liberty. And he said to me, he said, you can't touch stuff unless I tell you to. And then if you do it then, you're going to have to be an exhausted all measures of love before you touch it then. And I asked him, I said, why you show it to me for? He said, so you can pray. I'll show you everything I'll show you for you to bother with. Somebody need to tell her. No, somebody need to pray for her. He ain't told you to tell her. He told you to pray for her. He ain't told you to condemn her, put her down, or him down, or whatever. Pray for them. And so I had to learn. I couldn't bother stuff just because. And then I had to handle it in the right way. I had to be in the same spirit that he's speaking to me in. I can't be, well, see, I've been waiting on you anyhow. I got you now, buddy. I've been wanting to get you for a long time. that ain't none of the leading of the Spirit of the Lord. That's flesh.
Look out.
Think you got a justifiable reason. Come here, let me give you a word. Come here, let me give you a word. No, that's flesh. Come on, I'm out of time. What did it say? The Lord had opened my ears. Mm-hmm. Nah, who's the folks? See, they tried. The Lord God had given me the tongue of the learned, right? Mm-hmm. That I should know how to speak, right? Mm-hmm. And I tell you, you know how to speak because you listen right, right? Mm-hmm. Speak a word in season to him that is weary. He wakeneth morning by morning. He wakeneth my ear to hear as the learned, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so what that means is, you know, it's a principle, I believe, that in the mornings, a lot of times, the Holy Ghost will choose to speak to you, to set your day. You got it? A lot of times, before I come all the way to consciousness, he'll start, natural consciousness, he'll start talking to me. Oh, yeah. Laying in the bed, you know, and I'm about to wake up, but before I fully come to consciousness, he started talking to me. He started talking to me. You got it? And that sets the day. All right.